What are tracking cookies? And should they concern me? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. In a couple of other articles, What Can a Website I Visit Tell About Me? And What Are Browser Cookies and How Are They Used? I've discussed how websites gather information about the people who visit them. What I didn't talk about in much detail is that through clever use of cookies, typically associated with advertising, some services gather and use even more information about you. We need to talk about tracking and third-party cookies. So first, a quick review. A cookie is just some data placed on your computer when you visit a website, period. That's it. It's just some data. There's not even any definition of what that data should be. It's up to the website to drop that data on your machine. Then, the next time you visit that exact same website, that data that it left before is sent to the website. So for example, when you visit askleo.com, the website might place a cookie on your machine that says, this person has seen the newsletter pop up. A week later, when you visit askleo.com again, that cookie is automatically and transparently sent to the website, askleo.com, so that it knows you've already seen the newsletter pop up and it won't annoy you with it again. That's all that cookies are. They are a way for websites to remember things between visits. What they remember is completely up to them, but like I said, it could be pretty much anything. So, advertising. Most advertising on the internet is performed by services connecting large number of advertisers with large numbers of websites signed up to display ads. So, when you visit, say, example.com, you might see ads from ads.somerandomservice.com. Now, to be clear, all the URLs I'm using here are fictitious examples. Later, when you visit some other site, maybe reallybigbookstore.com, you might see ads there from that same advertising service, ads.somerandomservice.com. When your browser loads the page from example.com, the HTML on that page says, in effect, place an image here and get the image from ads.somerandomservice.com. At which point your browser dutifully goes out to ads.somerandomservice.com and gets the image, which is an ad. That's where cookies enter the picture. When your browser fetches a URL, be it the page you asked for or an element on that page, like an ad, the website it contacts can place cookies on your machine. So when you go to example.com, then of course example.com can place cookies. However, if that page also references another website, like ads.somerandomservice.com, for an image on that page, then that site, ads.somerandomservice.com, can also place cookies on the machine. These are called third-party cookies. You're the first party. The site you visit is the second party, example.com in our example. And then the sites that are referenced for additional content by the site you visited are the third party, ads.somerandomservice.com in the example. So far, so good. You visit a site, it can place cookies, and the sites that provide additional content on that page can also place cookies. Here's where it gets interesting. Let's walk through the scenario step by step. You visit example.com. Example.com has ads that are loaded from ads.somerandomservice.com. The first time you visit example.com, ads.somerandomservice.com puts a cookie on your machine that says, this is advertising visitor number 12345678. Now, you go visit reallybigbookstore.com, a completely different website, but it happens to use the same ad service. Ads.somerandomservice already has a cookie on your machine. So when the request is made to display an ad in reallybigbookstore.com from ads.somerandomservice.com, that cookie that ads.somerandomservice.com placed on your machine when you visited the earlier site is now uploaded and provided again as you visit this other site. Ads.someRandomService sees the cookie it put down earlier that said, this is advertising visitor number 12345678. Ads.someRandomService now knows that you, advertising visitor 12345678, visited both example.com and reallybigbookstore.com. That's a tracking cookie at work. Third parties use cookies to understand where you go on the net within the sites that they service. Now, so far, all I've talked about is advertising services. In reality, this simple technology can and does span more services. For example, you may have heard of a company called Google. They have their fingers in many, many pies. Advertising. AdWords for advertisers and AdSense for website owners who want to make money from ads. Analytics. Google Analytics, a comprehensive analysis tool that allows websites to understand how people use and find their sites. Personal productivity. Gmail, contacts, calendar, and more. Cloud services, Google Drive, photo sharing, YouTube, and more. Personal publishing services like Blogger. The list probably goes on. It's a very long list. The net result is that by interacting directly with a Google service or interacting with a site that uses a Google service, you are exposed to many opportunities for Google to leave tracking cookies on your machine. And it's not just Google. They're just a large, easy-to-understand example. The same is true for a varying degrees of other advertising networks and behind-the-scenes online service providers. Okay, I can hear you saying, aren't we blocking third-party cookies? Yes, we are, for the most part. But it seems like this would invalidate much of what I'd listed above. Sadly, that's often not the case. With third-party cookie blocking on the rise, advertisers and other services have developed other approaches. Tracking still happens via cookies, so-called ever cookies or local storage, on-page information, and more. It's more complex for sure, but it's not that difficult. That's why you'll still sometimes see ads that follow you around the internet, even if you had third-party cookies disabled. Okay, who cares? I've said this many, many times. My fervent belief is that your actions as an individual are completely uninteresting. No one cares. No one is tracking you personally. Besides, most of these services collect way too much data to drill down to any one person. Instead, this type of tracking is examined in aggregate. For example, with this data, the advertiser can determine things like 40% of the people who visit example.com also visit reallybigbookstore.com. None of them say or care that Leo Notenboom visited both example.com and reallybigbookstore.com. At best, they can say anyone who visited example.com and looked at X should then be shown ads for X when they visit reallybigbookstore.com. Note that it's anyone, generic, anonymous people, and not Leo Notenboom. Advertisers and website owners eat that stuff up. They use it to make decisions that support their profitability. But again, I believe strongly that Leo Notenboom just isn't that interesting as an individual. And please, don't take this personally, but neither are you. Bottom line here is, I don't sweat cookies or other targeted advertising. I know it can feel creepy, but I strongly believe they're not looking at you as an individual, but rather as anonymous people who behave in specific ways. That's it. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/3513. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.